Episode 3157, Reap a Harvest.
Moms, needing a little inspiration and a ray of hope? You've come to the right place. This is the show that you can turn to for just the pick-me-up you need. This is Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by.
Happy, happy day. Are you ready to dance into your week? Well, it is Sweet Spirit Sunday. Come on, it's so full food for your soul today. And I just want you to breathe because, okay, are you a college football person? I don't know. Have you watched some of those games? You may be scratching your head going, God, what team are you on? But we'll leave that one for another episode. Today, it's all about reap a harvest. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Galatians 6, verse 9 says this, "Let us not become weary in doing good, for at the proper time we will reap a harvest if we do not give up." Let that soak in for just a minute. You know, it's interesting. I come upon verses, and it's ones that I've heard years, decades ago, and then it comes up again at a different time, a different season, a different age of my life. And I look and I'm sitting there going, wow, this one jumped out at me. It was as if God said, Christiane, you need to hear this today. Now, it's not about that I don't do good and I feel weary about doing good. I don't. But sometimes that doing good is not just serving others in kindness, but also being kind to yourself. It's also going forward with what you know God has planned for your life. Because you see, in a culture that thrives on instant gratification and quick results, it can be disheartening when your efforts, especially in your journey of faith, don't yield immediate fruit. You desire instant transformation, instant answers to prayer, and instant confirmation that you are on the right path. I know I've been doing that. I have been asking God for that for a long time. But it is during these moments that Galatians chapter 6, verse 9 resonates deeply within your soul, right? Reminding you to persist and trust in God. Sometimes we have to be willing to step out in faith, right? Are you always wanting to see things to believe? Are you willing to take and accept the things unseen to believe? The journey of faith is a marathon, not a sprint. These words remind you that your walk with God is not a short, fleeting race, but rather an enduring journey that requires persistence, patience, and unwavering trust. You know, it's easy to grow weary, to question your efforts, and to doubt whether your labor of love is being noticed. However, in those moments, God gently whispers to your soul, "Hang on, child, your labor is not in vain." This verse from Galatians challenges you to redefine your understanding of reward. You know, our world teaches us that success is measured by quick returns and immediate gratification. But God invites you to find your ultimate fulfillment in his everlasting arms. He urges you to choose his timing over your impatience, assuring you that your harvest, well, it will come. And when it does, it will surpass your wildest dreams. Reap a harvest. So what areas of your life require more patience and perseverance? Are you facing challenges in relationships, your career, or personal growth? Maybe you're doing something different in your business. Maybe some things are happening in your marriage. Whatever the circumstances may be, remember that God's timing is perfect, even when it tests your patience. So take heart, my friend, for your harvest is on its way. And also, I want you to think about this. In those moments of waiting, press on and sow seeds of love, kindness, and faithfulness. Cultivate the soil of your heart with prayer. Seek wisdom through his word and serve others selflessly. Remember that faith without action is merely a wish, but faith coupled with patience and perseverance, well, it brings forth a bountiful harvest. In the face of challenges, seek God's strength. Pray earnestly for his guidance. Lean on his promise that he will never leave you nor forsake you. He promised that. It is through your reliance on his strength that you find the endurance to keep running the race, even when the path seems long and rugged. My friend, do not lose heart. Have faith in the process and your journey. Trust that God is working behind the scenes, going before you, aligning everything perfectly for his purpose. Your labor of love is not in vain. Your harvest will come, I promise you. And it will be more abundant, fulfilling, and beautiful than you can ever imagine. Now, will it look like you think it should? I can't promise that it will be exactly what you think. But I will tell you this. God's plan, his divine plan for you, is much better than anything you can dream of, anything you can imagine. So let us not become weary in doing good, for at the proper time, we will reap a harvest if we do not give up. Don't give up, my friend. Let this verse here in Galatians be a gentle reminder to persevere, to find joy in the present, and to place your hope in the one who holds your future. Go in peace. Be present. Be incredible. Be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious, blessed week. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.